little crazy. And no, we get a little loud. And no, we're never gonna fake it. We are wild, we are free, we are more than you think. So count us freaks. But that's just the way. And no, we get a little crazy. And no, we get a little loud. And no, we're never gonna fake it. We are wild, we are free, we are more than you think. So count us freaks. Cause that's just the way we roll.
I'm Erin.
And I'm Erica.
And you're watching our channel.
So today we are going to do something fun. We listened to you guys and like more than 20 people requested twin misconceptions and kind of common things that we could ask as twins. So that is what we're doing today.
And before we start, backstory just a little bit. So in sophomore year of college, sophomore year we took a creative writing course, which was really interesting. It was entitled Me, Myself, and I, and it was all about like coming of age stories and like discovering your individuality and stuff. And so in light of like kind of like researching and just like thinking back of like different things we can say to you guys on here, I remember that I wrote a final paper for that class and tons of papers that I'm gonna put on my blog, which you can all watch.
Want a break?
My mouth is so dry, I don't know why. But I brought up my final paper, and this is how I started it. Are you ready? Can you imagine living your life with an exact replica of yourself by your side, like a sister or a best friend, except one that looks like you, acts like you, and even thinks like you? It sounds crazy, right? Unreal, ridiculous, fictional, absurd, bizarre. Normal is the term we would use to describe it.
Yes, true. Erin's a really good writer.
So is Erica.
Thank you.
I'm going to post its chapters, so I have, like, it's a whole thing. I'm going to talk too much, and then we're going to have to edit it out. So, it's chapters. I'm going to post it. So if that sounds interesting to you, then follow me on Instagram if you don't want to post my blog.
Or just realized, too.
What?
We didn't plan to both have our hair in ponytails, so that's funny.
I'll just put your hair in a pony.
Ben had it in a pony. Okay, so I wrote some down, and I got some other questions on my phone, so let's get
this party started.
Okay, so you ready? First one we will do.
Who's older?
Yep, we get that all the time.
Right now you're all thinking, you're all throwing out names. No, you're not. You're like, stop, just say it. Me. Bye. Four. Whole minutes.
We do get asked that a lot. Some twins are like a minute apart, and then some are like 10. So,
and some even have different birthdays because they're born on like, or different, born in different years, because if you're born on New Year's, you're born in like 1159 versus like 1201.
All right, born. Do you feel each other's pain?
Yes.
We definitely do. I actually have a story I can tell about that. Let's think. When I was two years old, I was shopping with my mother at a grocery store. And she was there, and my older sister was there shopping around. And I was sitting in the carriage. And my sister was just like playing with me, and she stepped on the carriage, and she didn't know, like unbeknownst to herself, she flipped carriage, and luckily at the last second my mom heard it, turned around and caught my head, but my leg slammed onto the ground and I broke my leg at 2 years old. Luckily I don't remember much of it, but anyways, point of my story is when the paramedics got there, Erin was crying so much that they ran up to her and thought she was the one that was hurt.
So yeah, true story. I don't remember because we were obviously two, and you don't really remember when you're two. But yeah, apparently I was like literally screaming my head off because my little two-year-old self was like, oh my God, what happened? So yeah, I can't really like tell you that I was sad, but obviously me screaming more than she was, and she broke her leg, indicates that was
she kind of felt my pain.
Case. And also, in general, I say we can feel each other's pain. Like, yeah. I'm thinking back to, like, our life, like, boy situations. Like, there's been times where, like, something happened with Erica and a boy or something, and Erica's, like, stressed about it or just, like, I don't even know. And I have not. Like, do you remember that time when I wrote you a whole message? Yeah. I was like, I couldn't sleep, and I was analyzing the situation, and I think this is what happened. Like, I, like, just, like, yeah, we've...
Partially because she's a social worker, and partially because she's...
Yeah, and that made me just the empath in me, but, like, no, it's because it's you too. Like, it's, like, I'd rather have it be me with the issue sometimes.
Next question. Bum, bum, bum. Can you tell what each other is thinking? That kind of goes hand in hand with
that. What am I thinking right now?
Erin is thinking, she's hungry.
Nice. Yeah, no. Kind of, no.
No, well, I think that there are times when you can feel when someone, when one of the twins is thinking something. I worded that weird. But, like, one night Erin was sleeping, and we had gone to bed, but I was up for some reason, and I literally texted, or she texted me.
I sent it to you. Go to it in preparation for this.
The screenshot?
Yeah. It was this summer, last summer.
Oh, right here. It says, I'll read it to you and then we'll pop it up. It says, 6:19 a.m. I texted her and I said, can't sleep.
Slanty face.
She said, same. I said, OMG, I knew it. I literally could feel that you were awake. Weird. And Erin put on the picture. Twin telepathy is not real. Bet.
But yeah, wait, what was the question we're answering?
Can you tell what each other's thinking?
Yeah, we can. I mean, like, well, living the same experience, growing up as twins, so living the same household and having all experiences. If you think about, like, in science class or math class when you're growing up and teachers ask, like, does anyone know what I'm talking about? Or, like, anyone family experience or have experience that speaks to this? It's so annoying because if Erica's hands goes up, I'm like, dang it. Like, I'm going to say what she's going to say. That's so true. So then, like, if she gets called on and then the teacher's like, Erica first and then Erin, I'm like, no, I'm not going to be able to because Erica will tell the story. I'll be like, one time, like, even, like, we just had, we're social work majors, but you know if you watch our first video. We had, what was the class called? Practice Abusers of Alcohol and Other Substances.
Yes.
And we both had, like, the same stories, the same family members and same stuff. So it was always just, like.
Yeah, it's always like that. Blessing and a curse. Do you guys sound alike? So I think that we partially do.
You want to say a sentence and then I'm gonna say the exact same one because I kind of want to hear it too when we listen to this.
Okay. So I will say
choose a sentence.
I am really enjoying having a YouTube channel.
I am really enjoying having a YouTube channel.
I feel like you altered your voice in that.
I think I did too.
Okay.
I am really enjoying having a YouTube channel.
Anyways, we do sound alike, but Erin's voice is lower. That's what we get.
I feel like you put the camera really low and I had to, like, bend down.
Me too.
You did.
Sorry, guys.
Because usually I'm like this, but, like, if I'm like this, it's like you can't see me, so.
Sorry.
If you're wondering why I'm fidgeting, I'm calling myself out. So I don't have to do it in words, I can call it out.
So, yes, we do sound alike, but my voice is higher, hers is lower. Next.
This is a big insecurity of mine. I don't know why.
Do you guys wear the same clothes?
Oh, yeah.
We share
everything. It's really nice. Like, I go shopping. It's so, as a twin, or for us, personal experience, I, like, cannot go shopping without Erica. Because, like, I'm so indecisive. Yes. Like, I feel like these pants are cute, but, like, what is Erica thinking? Like, Erica, will we wear these? Are these cute? So, like, going shopping without her is, like, I mostly don't buy anything. I'm like, we'll go together. Because we share our everything, like, every single thing and all of, we have so many clothes because, like, we have double, our older sister moved out, and her room is filled with, her closet's filled, her dressers, and we have, like, yeah, we were thinking we might sell some old clothes, because we, like, get shirts and wear them, like, one time. Yep.
Bend down. Oh, I was gonna say something about that is, The good thing about
the hunchback
wearing the same clothes is that when we go to the mall or we go shopping and one of us doesn't feel like trying something on, like, we'll pick a designated, like, you're trying something on today. Yes, we're pretty much the same.
We're the same size, yeah.
Okay, next. Do you guys fight? We touched upon this, but yeah. We definitely fight, but it's over the stupidest things. And like I said in the last video, I won't spend a lot of time on this, but when we do fight, we know how to really stab each other.
I really am hating that I have to bend down here.
Do you want to move it? Or just leave it. Leave it.
I go on to this. Dang, I forgot what I was gonna say. Oh yeah, we don't have like those real life fights where like sisters don't talk for weeks or like friends. And you're like, we're not friends anymore. We're not sisters anymore. Like we have like what she just said. Like, it's so crazy. We have the same thoughts. Like really, twin telepathy. Like I'm not kidding. There will be a shirt that neither of us have worn in like 2 years, and I'll somehow have a dream that shirt looks good or see a picture, and I'll be like, I'm gonna wear that tomorrow. And I'll wake up and I'll be peeing in the bathroom before picking out my outfit, and I'll walk in here and Eric will have it on. I'll be like, hot, like what the hell, like I want to wear that shirt. And then we'll get into a fight and I'll be like, take it off, and she'll be like, no. And then but sure. Like we can't really, we resort to like insulting, but like what are we gonna say, like you're ugly, like so
we do say it though. Okay. Next. Did you guys ever switch places?
So we might have touched upon this a little bit too. No, we don't. So in middle school, in elementary school, obviously not. In elementary school, you have to follow the rules, or you move to office and everyone follows the rules. We were followers. We still are, kind of. But in middle school, I dyed my hair, which you guys saw. And if you didn't see, go look at it, because it's fun. It's our last video.
So our moral of the story is that if we switch places,
it was not nice.
Our teachers would be able to tell.
Yeah, that was my next sentence, not a moral of the story. It was a karma speaking fact.
And to be honest, I would literally... Yeah. Break down if I was like trying to take a test for something. I'd be like, I'm Erica.
Except to remember in seventh grade, right after I dyed my hair, what happened? My teacher saw Eric on the hallway and was like,
blonde hair.
Oh my god, you dyed your hair, because she didn't know I had a twin. We were on different teams, and she's like, it looks so much better, I love it. Erica thought it was the funniest thing, and I didn't, and I was like,
yeah.
So, and then she realized I told her,
I was like, oh, thank you so much. But like, I'm Aaron's twin, Erica. And she was like, I think she just didn't really know what to say.
She didn't know what to
She's
say.
Like, oh, okay.
And then she always tried to like compliment me. And I was like, you know what?
Okay.
I should have listened to her though. She was right. Reflecting back now.
Oh, so I see this one, just what's it like?
But yeah, no, we never switch places. We don't change boyfriends or anything like that, by the way.
Oh, that's another one. That's Do you guys share boyfriends? No. Her boyfriend is like my brother, literally. But actually at college, just in general, this is like, we would be playing like games and stuff, and I'm just better at beer pong than Aaron. I just am. So she was trying to play one night with her boyfriend, and she just didn't want to do it anymore, I guess, right? She just walked away. So I just took her place. But I guess a lot of people who like were watching didn't really realize that we switched or see us switch. So, her boyfriend had like walked away in a minute and like gave her a kiss as she was like with everyone else, and everyone looked at him and then looked at me and looked at her, and they were like, wait, what? Because they thought that she was me. They didn't see us switch.
Yeah.
And they're like, do you date both of them? So
people like started dapping up Justin, like,
but no.
Ew, no.
No.
Or her boyfriend like just moved in for like the whole coronavirus, because his family was in Cape Cod, and it was just this whole thing, whatever. And he's like my brother. Like, we're literally like, we like tag team on Erica, and like, it's like we love each other.
And they can tell us apart.
Love each other's boyfriends, but it's like not in that way. It's just like the brother love, you know.
The only time they ever mix us up is if they're drinking and we're turned back. Like from the back, we look very similar.
My boyfriend Justin has. We've been dating since 2012, so there's been times where he has, like, acted like he was, like, giving Erica a hug, and I'm like, aw. But I'm like, you totally thought that was me.
He said, oh, my God, I thought you were Aaron.
But he's always been able to tell us apart.
Oh, yeah.
And he could totally, I mean, obviously now. And all of our friends can tell us apart, too.
And then just in general, because someone said, do people mix you guys up? And from experience, people totally mix us up. Like, our professors don't really know who's who.
We had all of our classes together, so, like, we couldn't switch places, like I said. But they, like, would act like they knew who we were. And then if we, like, switched, like, if I sat on the left instead of the right one day.
No clue. And during our freshman year, mostly freshman, sophomore year of college, when we would, I would just be walking on campus, and I would see someone, and they would say hi to me, and I knew, no, I never saw them before, like, or interacted with them, but I would just go with it, because, like, I'm like, oh, they totally think I'm Aaron. Even professors, But it's because like she had orientation and I had orientation like groups separately. So some people just didn't know or they just assumed. But yeah. But yeah. Once people got to know us usually.
Like I remember like seriously I would be walking through campus freshman year especially. And like someone would just be like, everyone trying to make friends freshman year. Some random person I've literally never seen before would be like, Erica. And that's another thing. Like, I don't know. We've talked about it. Like if I hear the name Erica, I respond. Yeah. So,
yeah, same.
Erica was just showing me, instead of just saying out loud, that's why we just looked weird. She was showing me that it's 14 minutes and she wanted to make the video short. So, sorry, it's fine. We'll wrap it up. But I respond to Erica.
And I respond to Erin.
But yeah, whatever. Freshman year, I just literally I remember like listening to a whole conversation and like feeling bad, not saying like, oh, I'm not Erica. And I would just go back and be like, Erica, I just had a conversation with someone and they thought I was you. So here's what happened. Here's what they said. And if you see them, just pretend because.
All right. We're going to do a couple more. Do you guys have similar tastes?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
We like the same things.
Like and it everything. Changes. I mean, I know your taste buds change every 7 years, but like we never really liked hot sauce. We weren't like huge. Like we tolerated it, but we didn't like put it on things. And then 21, 22, we are hot sauce. Like we literally can drink hot sauce. We were hot sauce fiends. And we always loved ice cream and like candy. I'm answering your questions. Don't rush me.
Oh, no, I wasn't.
Oh.
What was I just going to say? I don't remember. Now you stress me out. I don't remember.
I look twinning hard. Erica put her bangs up right now.
Oh, I was going to just preface this. I should have said this earlier, but this is for our experience. This isn't all twins. Some twins, I'm sure, don't like have different experiences. Just to put that out there. Parents confuse twins.
On occasion,
our parents are pretty good. Like all of our photographs, my mom is really good at labeling the back of them and just saying like Erica's on the right or Aaron's on the left or vice versa, whatever. But sometimes if I wear my hair back, my mom will completely think I'm her. But she'll be like, oh my God, like she'll say it. And then when she really looks at me, she can tell. But there have been a couple of times.
Yeah, but for the most part, they know.
Once
you get to hang out with us, like for people who meet us for the first time are like, oh my God. And then they're like, I can't believe it. Like, then when, if we like hang out for a while and they start to get to know us, they're like, I can't believe there was a time where I couldn't tell you apart. Like you're Erin and you're Erica. Cause like,
yeah,
we're different. That happened in college.
Our roommates, not really our roommates, but basically our roommates, Alexa and Hannah, they at first could not tell us apart. And then like almost immediately they're like, oh my God, I can't believe I couldn't tell you guys apart. You guys are like two different people, which is also true.
Once you know, you know. It's so crazy because we're like the same person. Like we're so similar, but we also are so different. Like we have our own
personalities.
Things.
Yeah, for sure. Okay. Do you twins have the same language? Wait,
the same language?
Do twins have their own language?
Yeah, we have our 100% complete own language. If you read our text messages, you would literally not know what we were saying.
No.
But, yeah.
Also, when we were little, when we were babies, I actually was just looking at my baby book because honestly, what really is there else to do in quarantine except reminisce and look at memories? I mean, if you haven't done that, here's a tip, do it. Anyways, I was looking at my baby book and my mom, I was reminded of the language we had when we were very little.
We don't remember having a language, but we had a language.
And we called each other Dodie, just Dodie. Doddy. So my mom said.
I was why?
I don't know. My mom said that one time they took us to the beach and they were getting nervous that everyone around was thinking that my parents named both of their daughters Jody.
Does it get annoying being a twin? Do you like being a twin? I'm just thinking off of personal thoughts. I don't get annoyed with being a twin. I love being a twin. It's hard because I started this with, you have like literally an exact replica. So talk about like comparison, like quote, comparison being the thief of joy. We can't not compare ourselves. Like, you know, like in regards to, we're also both have like crazy, like academic anxiety. We're very like, we're perfectionists. And I think that stems from being a twin. Cause you never want to be the dumber twin.
Yeah, it's a good kind of competition, but it's there.
Yeah,
for
but
sure.
So we're like literally always compared. So you interrupted me and I forgot where I was going because my mind is like, what was I saying? What did I start
with? I'll step in on you because I know what you're talking about a little bit. I wrote my senior thesis on...
I love being a twin. That's what I was talking about.
On identical twins and why some twins go to college together while others do not. And I won't get into the whole thing because it's a lot. It's really interesting. I could share it with people if anyone wanted to read my senior thesis, but it's a lot. I ended up finding commonality, like similarities and things that twins who went to college had in common versus those who didn't. Like for example, I interviewed a lot of twins, and there are so many twins on Providence College campus, I swear. Like, I thought we were going to be like special, like, I don't know, but there were so many twins. Anyways, a lot of the twins that went to school together, growing up, shared the same room. We went to school together.
We currently do. And also, we haven't addressed this yet, and so I'm addressing it. Go finish and I'll do it, so it's not all over the place.
They did not have classes together, and that's true for us too. Like, we were separated in school, like school separation, until our senior year of high school, but before that, all separate classes. And dressing the same until a certain age, which we did. It was just funny because all the people who did, like one of my good friends who lived next door to me my freshman year didn't go to this college with her twin. And she was like, yeah, no, like we didn't share a room, or like just the opposite. And it was really, really, really interesting trends that I found. But yeah.
Really interesting, like super duper, like crazy interesting.
It was.
No, it was so interesting. We were literally, we're nerds, and I was sitting on the bed with her, and we were so excited going through. We're like, oh my god, are we like breaking through with data? Like, we have to say, like, if they, we can hypothesize that if a twin doesn't share a room with a twin and they don't have the same class, and this can happen. We really, so I mean sarcasm. We do share a room. We've always shared a room. We have two extra rooms in my house now, and we don't want to have separate rooms.
Yes.
But yeah, when I couldn't think of what I was saying before, I was just saying, like, it's hard because you're compared, but it makes me, like, it makes us who we are, and it. Yeah, I love that. I literally pray that my kids have twins. I think being a twin is literally why I'm so positive. Like, I have you have a best friend. Like,
Villain best friend. That leads into a misconception. Having twins does not skip generations. I know that is a misconception.
I mean, I did know that until right this second.
Yeah.
Does my not. Face.
Another misconception is that we have the exact same fingerprints, which is not true, because they are affected by different elements.
Remember in bio, Meenerka Defy bio teacher, she said that all twins have the same, I don't know what they're called. Like, some people can...
Like mannerisms, kind of.
Yeah, like, can you do this? We both can do this, right? Some people can't do that. And that's just, it's a trait or something that you get. It's you get blue eyes. It's the same exact thing. And she's like, oh, the twins will be an example. Because they're twins and they're DNA, blah, blah, they'll be able to do, I'm not good with bio. They'll be able to do all the same things. And then we went like this. And this is another one. And my right hand crosses over my left, and Erica's naturally right hand goes over her. You probably don't know what we're doing, but do this. It's like whatever way naturally works for you is a trait you inherit from your parents.
This, and we're opposite. So mine, when I do it, when you don't think about it, mine go like this. I'm not thinking about it, and Erin goes like this. And this feels uncomfortable for me, and same for her.
And that's not supposed to happen, because we're twins. So we're identical twins. So I don't know. We defy bio. Who knows?
All right. We'll end with a funny story. So, because someone asked, like, funny stories to ask twins. So, I think you'll agree with me. In Italy, what would happen? So, we were in Italy.
Oh, my God.
And we were learning the language, but obviously we were, like, beginners. Like, I would mix it up with Spanish so much.
We took Spanish, and we were in the Spanish non-recital, and we were literally, like, not doing our homework. I was so good at Spanish. And then, I don't know what happened. We decided we were going to go to Italy.
I don't regret that at all. I loved Italy. Anyways.
It was hard with languages.
We knew that gemelle meant twin in Italian. So we were like, great, cool. So we're grocery shopping one day. Actually, multiple times. But we were grocery shopping, and this mother and this daughter, they were looking at us kind of like it usually happens. But in America, we can conversate and like talk and tell them. But so in Rome, we're shopping, and the woman goes, gemelle, gemelle. And we're like,
see.
So she starts talking to us in Italy, like, whole conversation, like, asking questions. And me and Aaron are like, oh, fuck. Like, we were like, and so what we did, instead of saying, like, we don't speak Italian, we were just like,
and we honestly, we smiled and shook our heads. We have no idea, but we might have gave her some misconceptions if she asked us. And we were like, yeah, we have the same boyfriend, yeah, because we have a really hard time, like, saying no and just not, like, well, all we had to say was we don't. Anyways, wait, I'm going to end with this, Erica. I wanted to tell you what I want to do.
This will count as our quote.
Okay. Hold on. Oh, yeah. And it will make you want to go read my,
Thank you for watching.
Okay, so, in my paper, this is what I say. So, we realize that twins have a much harder time figuring out who they are and distinguishing themselves as individuals. Truth. Now, I depict the struggles that twins face as they yearn desperately for a sense of individuality and seek this through difference. My overall theme, however, is again that, being a twin is something that you cannot escape, as it is a part of you. Thus, again, my message is that twins can identify as twins without losing their individuality. They don't need to be different in order to establish themselves as individuals, and can actually take solace in the sameness that they share.
Beautifully said. I was trying to bring up a misconception because that was a misconception. What she just said. I can't exactly find it.
Looking, I'm going to read more things. One thing that I realized about myself while crafting the story was that being a twin is a part of who I am, and I can identify as a twin without losing my individuality. I realized that I would not be the person I am today if it weren't for my twin sister, Erica. In fact, I realized that I would not be as smart, driven, motivated, etc. if I did not have a twin sister to push me to continuously work harder and harder. And now...
The misconception, quick, was it was that twins lose their individuality if they're not separated. And that was a misconception, but I think there are some truths to that, because you become dependent on one another. I think if we were together all the time, it's nice kind of doing something separately.
And if you want to find out what it's like growing up, if you want to read a coming-of-age story as a twin, and more what it's like to be a twin in kindergarten, I start chapter 1, 7th grade, so middle school, twin, and then I did sophomore year of college. You can see the transformations. My story's called, I'm going to put on my blog, maybe my Insta, I don't know, I'll link it somewhere. We are twins, but who am I?
And I can also share my senior thesis about twins if anyone's interested, on my blog maybe, or my social media.
Anyway, and
that's it.
Our quote is, having a twin is having someone to double your joys and divide your sorrows.
That's all.
Thank you for watching.
Peace out. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. And I thank you so much for the suggestions and for like communicating with us, because now we get to do what you like.
We're gonna do our workouts, to do what we eat in a day, some challenges.
You said this last time. Thank you for watching.
Thanks for watching.